In this segment, we will just introduce you to the micromechanical analysis for lamina. So what this simply means is that we have the properties of the fiber and the matrix. And from there, we want to be able to find out what the overall properties of the lamina are. So let's go and look at what the assumptions are. So as you can see from the picture on the left, that we have, this is a non-homogeneous lamina. That means that at every place, the properties will be different. Like you have a fiber here, you have a matrix here, you have a fiber here, you have a matrix here. So you're finding out that this is a non-homogeneous lamina. But for all practical purposes, for our analysis, we're going to assume that it is made of a homogeneous layer, as opposed to a non-homogeneous layer, which you're seeing here. So that's an approximation which we do make for the micromechanical analysis of a lamina. So the question is that why do we need micromechanics in lamina? So if you go back and look at the macro analysis of a single lamina, we found out that we're using 13 properties. We used 4 elastic moduli, 5 strength parameters, 2 thermal expansion coefficients, and 2 moisture expansion coefficients. And that makes it a number to be 13. So we have to somehow find these. Now, surely we can conduct experiments to be able to find out these 13 parameters, but that can become quite expensive, because we may have a different amount of fiber, different amount of matrix in it, different kinds of fibers. So in order to be able to do this experimentally and find some meaningful values out of it, it'll become quite difficult. So we do need to do some kind of a modeling technique to be able to find out these 13 parameters. And we may have to couple it with some experimental numbers as well to be able to come up with these 13 parameters. So what we are basically doing is that we're saying, hey, there's fiber and there's matrix in this unidirectional lamina. So we're only interested in the unidirectional lamina because we already know that how to take care of the angle lamina once we know the properties of a unidirectional lamina. So these particular numbers which you're seeing here will depend on the volume fraction. What that means is that, hey, how much of the fiber is in there? How much of the matrix is in there? What is the fiber made of? What is the manufacturing process? So all of those are going to affect these 13 properties which you're seeing here. And so that's why, although we're talking about we need 13 parameters here, we will be interested in the volume fraction of the fibers, volume fraction of the matrix. We call it the weight fraction of the fiber and the weight fraction of the matrix. The reason why we are interested in weight fractions is because overall, what are we looking for in composite? We want to reduce weight, right? We want to reduce mass of the structure. So we do need to talk about weight fractions as well. And also, when you're going to order something, you'll be ordering by weight and not by volume. And then also, of course, we will need to know the density of the composite. And this also becomes important for several reasons. One is that if you remember your introduction to composite material in chapter 1, we talked about, hey, we want materials with high specific modulus. That involves E divided by rho type of qualities, right? Or we need high specific strength. That requires ultimate strength divided by density. So we want low density and high strengths and high moduli. So in order to figure out, hey, how good these materials are, we do need to calculate the density. Also, what's going to happen is that this density is going to come into the picture when we derive the formulas for the moisture expansion as well. So that's why these things, these three additional variables you're seeing here of volume fraction, weight fraction, and density become important. So the bottom line is that we want to do macromechanics of a lamina, but in order to do the macromechanics of lamina, we need these 13 parameters. And that's what this whole chapter is all about, because the macromechanics of lamina will allow us to do the macromechanics of a laminate. And laminates are the ones which are in actual structures. So you can see the connection between these three chapters, macromechanics of lamina, micromechanics of lamina, and macromechanical analysis of a laminate. And that is the end of this segment.